Adventures of the Saint, starring Vincent Price. The Saint, based on characters created by Leslie Charteris and known to millions from books, magazines, and motion pictures. The Robin Hood of modern crime now comes transcribed to radio, starring Hollywood's brilliant and talented actor Vincent Price as the Saint.
Come in.
Hi, Mr. Templeton.
Oh, hello, Louie.
Where are you?
I'm in my room. I'll be ready in a minute.
Hey, wait till you see my cab. I gave it a bath for Christmas.
Well, congratulations.
Yeah. Look, I don't want to rush you, but if you don't hurry, Christmas Eve is going to be already Christmas morning. And what'll all them tots think?
Oh, them tots will be singularly fortunate. However, all I have to do now is get my whiskers on. There. How do I look?
Mr. Templar, if I didn't know you was Mr. Templar,
yes.
I wouldn't know who you were.
Louis, don't I look like Santa Claus?
This may come as a surprise to you, Mr. Templar. Santa Claus is fat.
Oh.
You're not fat.
Oh, well, hand me that cushion from the couch, huh?
Okay. Here.
Yeah, thank you. Now then. How's that?
Now say ho, ho, ho.
What for?
Santa Claus is always say ho, ho, ho.
Oh, I see. Ho, ho, ho.
Well, anyway, you look like Santa Claus. Hey, Mr. Temple, whose idea was this?
Mrs. Winterbottom's.
Oh, the dame who annoys tots on Christmas Eve.
Mrs. Winterbottom is a very well-known philanthropist, and every Christmas Eve she collects hundreds of small children and feeds them.
Yeah. Who feeds them the rest of the year?
Don't be bitter, Louis.
Sorry.
At least I ought to give the little tots a laugh.
Yeah. And I suppose there is something to be said for Mrs. Winterbottom.
Don't say it now.
Don't worry.
There's something to be said for Santa Claus, too. He does go around filling stockings.
Yeah, I know a blonde. Shouldn't say that either, huh?
No. Someone at the door. Louis, would you mind?
No. It's probably one of them tots. Correction. It's a tot 20 years later.
Get in.
I'm already in.
Back up.
I'm backing up.
Thanks. Now reach, gents.
You know, that gun in her hand looks loaded.
Now that you mention it.
Reach.
For what?
The chandelier.
I can't.
Why not?
No chandelier.
Oh, a wise guy, huh?
If you're going to shoot me, I insist on knowing your name.
Just call me Sally.
Sally. And your last name?
Never mind that. How would you like to get plugged in the...
Breadbasket?
Where?
Oh, let's pass lightly over that. I wouldn't like to get plugged anywhere.
And shut up.
All right.
Where is it?
Right down the hall.
Are you trying to be smart?
Not especially.
So it's going to be like that, huh?
Like what?
Now you listen to me, Fats Boylan.
Huh?
You shut up, too.
I didn't say anything.
Well, shut up anyway.
I'm shutting up.
What was I saying?
You just finished calling me Fats Boylan.
That's right.
That's wrong. I'm not Fats Boylan.
Ha. Huh.
Well, it helps keep the conversation
Look,
going.
Look, Fats, but... are you going to stop stalling and hand over the stuff, or will I have to shoot?
Since I am not Fats Boylan, and since I have no stuff to hand over, I'm afraid you'll have to shoot.
Mr. Templar, that could be fatal.
You keep quiet, punk.
Who's a punk?
You're a punk.
Mr. Templar, am I a punk?
Well, Sally is just a little confused this evening,
confused
Louis.
Confused or not, she shouldn't call me a...
Oh, shut up. Oh.
You don't have to start bawling.
I am not. I
You were just about to shoot me.
Well, I know, but then you'd bleed.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I can't stand the sight of blood.
Why don't you strangle him?
Louis, don't be unkind. It seems to be the doorbell again.
No, wait.
Oh, it's very impolite to keep people waiting.
But I must have been followed here.
Sally, look, stop illustrating a point with that gun. It might go off.
I don't care.
But then I'd bleed.
But where can I go? I've got to hide.
Well, try the kitchen.
All right.
Oh, come on in. It's open house tonight.
Well, well, my old pal, Fats.
I am not.
Boylan.
Although I'm beginning to waver. Perhaps I am. Simon, the split personality. Who are you?
Well, Joe Hudson. You remember your old pal, Hudson.
Hudson, Well, I must admit you look like a hornet, but your lines aren't as nice. Look, if I'm your old pal, why don't I know you?
Oh, that's easy. We never met personally.
Well, how else can you meet? Ignore that. But if we haven't met personally or otherwise, how can I be your pal?
Oh, I was just being friendly. Besides,
Hey, you got something for me.
I have?
Great little kidder, ain't you, Fats? Ain't he, pal?
Now I feel better. I'm a pal, too.
Look, I wish I deserved your delighted choice.
Look, just leave me have the stuff, and then I'll get...
Stuff again. What stuff?
Am I going to have trouble with you?
The door behind you is open. Why don't you use it, huh? In that way, nobody will have any trouble.
I'll use it after.
After what?
Sounds like that, huh? Ever see one of these before?
I'm afraid I'm going to disappoint you, but the answer is yes, I have.
Good. Then you know how it works. It shoots bullets at guys. Guys who get bullet shot at them have a habit of dying.
Really? Well, then perhaps you'd better not shoot that gun at me.
I won't. So gimme.
So I ain't got. Well, that is, I...
That is, you ain't got.
Thanks, Louis.
Basic, I ain't a patient man. Hand the stuff over, or
I don't have any stuff.
Or you get shot.
I'd bleed.
Who cares?
I do. I hoped you might. However...
This could be a stall. This could be trouble, so you...
You can't shoot him.
Why not?
It's against the law. I read it in the papers. It's against the law.
Yeah, I believe you.
Oh, well, so that's okay.
Yeah, but I like doing things against the law.
Oh. Well, you could go to jail.
I already been there.
Well, for shooting somebody, they'll hang you or something.
If somebody told them.
Well, I would.
You would, huh?
I would.
So maybe I'd better shoot you first.
Well, I wouldn't want to deprive Mr. Templar of the privilege.
Well, Fats, it's your last chance.
Oh, not that phrase. Also, I still don't
know... So it looks like I'm going to break a law.
Hey, who did that?
You did, you dope.
I did not. This here is a plan. But you won't get away with it.
Goodbye, Mr. Hudson.
Mr. Templar, who made with the artillery?
It must have been Sally. She's in the kitchen.
She can stay there.
She saved our lives, Louis.
Yeah, but maybe by now she's found out she likes to shoot guns.
Let's hope not.
Hello.
It was nice of you to frighten Mr. Hudson off.
I did?
You did.
I didn't hit anybody?
No.
Oh, I'm so glad.
Hey, I've got her.
She's out cold.
Come on, I'll put her on the couch. Yeah. Come on.
It's a little late, but somebody ought to mention she is not a bad-looking dish.
You've mentioned it.
Looking for smelling salts in our bag?
No, identification. Here's a driver's license. Her name is Sally Walters. Address, 49 Arden Drive. Social security card. She's the secretary.
That's what I need. Take it back.
She's coming, too. Better put the bag back.
Yeah, but keep the gun, though. There's still some bullets in it.
No, we don't want her to know we went through her bag.
We're ashamed of ourselves?
We're going to pay her a visit.
She ain't home.
But she will be after she leaves here, and then perhaps we can find out what keeps the home fires burning.
Sally was in kind of a hurry leaving us.
So she was.
Mr. Templar, don't look right, Santa Claus chasing a blonde.
I'm not chasing her.
Technicalities will get you no place. Hey, this must be it. 49. What is she a secretary of? The Treasury?
I suspect this is where she works, Louis.
She works overtime, huh?
Yeah, and probably sleeps in. Come on.
Yeah. I hope that nobody is peeking because they'll think Santa Claus is off schedule.
I think perhaps I can manage without the whiskers.
Yeah.
Ouch!
Now you look like an imposter.
Would you ring, Louie?
Okay. You know, this is the type house I got a feeling Santa Claus would have to use the servants' entrance.
Yes.
I'm Simon Templar.
You are?
I am.
There's nothing I can do about it.
Mr. Templar, all butlers are like him?
I doubt it. I think he's been practicing.
Haw.
Haw.
Well, good night, then.
I think not.
Would you mind removing your shoe from the door?
I would.
You might at least have shined it.
Humphrey, whoever is it at this time of night?
No one, madam.
Oh, but such an interesting-looking no one. Santa Claus, you've lost your whiskers.
I haven't. They're right here in my pocket.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.